It's Officer Wright.
Yes?
Are you Watson Gowan?
Yes.
Well, it's good to meet you, Watson. I'm Officer Wright, and this is my partner, Officer Rusatella.
Hi, Watson. Nice to meet you.
Hi.
We're actually here, Watson, because we have a mutual friend.
We do?
We do. And that mutual friend asked us to come by and say hello to you. You know who that might be? It's actually your mother, Watson.
My mother?
You could be waiting for a day that won't come, and you could be so much more than you've become. And I have found my feet 7 weeks, but you could be waiting for a day that won't come. You could be waiting for your life to begin, and you could be so much more than you've been. And I have found my feet 257 weeks, but you could be waiting for your life to begin. And it's so sad, you're so good and I'm so bad, but you
Okay, so I moved to Connecticut from New York so I could work part-time and concentrate on my writing. I figured the only difference between me and, say, like, Kira Sedgwick and Kevin Bacon was they moved here once they hit it big, but I did it before. I figured that way I'd be here once I did hit it big.
I think I'm the one who suggested it to Watson. I mean, I was so over the Hamptons. Connecticut's much more subtle. Besides, it's easier for me to get to, and a train leaves every hour from Grand Central.
Above and beyond all that, the absolute best thing about Connecticut is my Volvo.
Is that your Mitsubishi outside?
Yeah, but it's a rental. It's...
Well, she said she asked you to exchange that for a full-size car. Then at least you wouldn't be driving a compact car on the highway.
Officer, when I was growing up in New York, my mother... excuse me. Thank you. My mother refused to take cabs unless the seatbelts worked.
Well, she said it's because you grew up in the city that you don't have any driving experience.
Well, I have to learn, don't I?
Sometime.
That's what I told her. But she is pretty upset. Now, look, your mother cares a great deal about you, Watson. She's a real nice lady.
I know.
I wanted her in a tank.
And believe me, I researched it. I read consumer reports. I consulted with my attorneys. I spoke to my friends here in Palm Beach. And everyone agreed the Volvo is the safest car out there. And my attorney felt very strongly we should buy it new. He said, you really never know what you're getting otherwise. I mean, imagine if we were to buy a used Volvo and only to find out that it had been owned by some crack addict who tampered with the odometer.
Now, statistically speaking, your mother is onto something. Compact cars fold up like accordions in head-ons.
And those airbags are for shit.
Oh.
Watson had just moved to Connecticut. She didn't have a job yet. She was getting her feet wet. So, I took care of the monthly payments myself.
Most kids' first cars are their parents' old sedan, or a used Honda, or even a new Honda. Mine was a brand new silver Volvo S70 with anti-locks, power seats, power windows, power sunroof, and a five-cylinder that went from 0 to 60 in under 8.
But then I bought an apartment in an all-cash building. And Watson was working by then. I mean, she had a job at some sort of blue-collar company. Oh, you know these artists. Anything to pay the rent. So I said, Watson, I'm sorry, but you are going to have to be responsible for the monthly Volvo payments from now on, yourself.
So, Watson, 10 copies of the reports for both budgets, bound with our summaries. You're on it, right?
Actually, I didn't...
I put it in your inbox. I need it tonight.
Right, I'm on it. No problem.
Contrary to your opinion, an inbox is more than a file holder.
This is one of the reasons I moved to Connecticut.
Well, it sure as hell ain't no D'Agostino's baby cakes.
Oh my God! Buy one, get one free!
Ian, Ian, Ian! He's here.
Who?
Register for.
Register for.
He's new. His name is Jack.
Jack?
Shh. Isn't he hot?
Not bad. You realize he might not have any hair in 3 years. But I'd do him.
I always go through his checkout now. I try to buy something every few days just so I can see him. And it is so cute because he's still in training and he gets all confused with vegetables.
He is going to love us then.
Oh, no, 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 no!
What?
He's gonna think that we're together.
What do you think, 3 or 4 of these?
No, Ian, I am serious. He's gonna see us when we check out and think that we're dating or something. You can't go through with me.
Come on, I want a shot at him too.
No way. When we're done, you can go get a gumball or something.
No, please, I was just kidding. I want to go. I want the full suburban experience. I want to see what kind of scanners they use and how fast their conveyor belt thingamabobber is.
Okay, then talk about Malcolm.
And say what?
I don't know, talk about how you guys were, like, picking out wallpaper together or something.
That is so obvious.
Well, what do you suggest?
Oh, I could tell him about that time Malcolm gave me head on the subway.
Can't you just wait outside?
Oh my God, there's a sale on cauliflower.
No, I am serious. Hi.
Hi. Do you have a super savings card?
Oh yeah. It's in here somewhere. I definitely have one. I'm like always buying the stuff on sale.
Ah, here. I'll just use this one.
Oh, thanks. I don't know where mine went. I'll probably find it the minute you're done.
This.
Basil. That's basil.
Paper or plastic?
Plastic.
I can't believe what Lagerfeld is doing this year with Chanel. Have you seen this?
No. It's Greenlee, Boston. Actually, it's Greenlee.
It is Boston.
Look at this! Isn't this heinously, vituperously dreadful?
Yeah, I guess so.
Shallots?
No, that's portobello. It's a mushroom.
I mean, it would work if it was for his own line, but not for Chanel. It is totally wrong for Chanel.
I'm gonna need to check some ID for this.
Oh, sure.
Isn't he gorgeous? What I wouldn't give. Goose, goose, goose.
He's definitely more your type than mine. Mm.
Thanks. That's 2436, please.
Did you see how he asked me for my license?
Yeah.
Now he knows my name. And did you notice that he didn't even ask me to find my Super Saver card? He just trusted me enough to use the register copy. That's a good sign, don't you think? I mean, between that and the license.
You're kidding, right? I mean, you didn't even flirt with him.
I did too.
When?
I was flirting with him when I told him what all the produce was. Did you hear me? It was in my tone of voice.
What was that whole like thing all about?
What do you mean?
He was like, my driver's license, Jack. That's like portobello. Jack, were you trying to sound like a mall slut?
I said it once, Ian, once. Cut me some slack, you know? I was a little intimidated by that lanky 90210 wannabe.
Oh.
Did you see how she was breathing down my neck?
That vile bagger bitch. She had $10 store written all over her.
So you don't think he could tell that I liked him, even with the way that I said basil?
I highly doubt it.
All right, let's go back.
What?
I'll just grab some olive oil.
Watson, we are not going back in there. We are going home and starting the ratatouille, which has to simmer for about 12 and a half hours anyway, by which point we will be so completely starving, we'll have to come back and get something to snack on.
Well, what if his shift is over by then?
Well, you're just gonna have to risk it, baby.
Anyway, he is not at an express lane. It'd be too obvious buying olive oil.
All right, maybe you're right.
I'm always right.
But I did flirt with him. It was in the sound of my voice. It was very seductive.
A little while ago, I was reading this book by Topak Chopsticks, Happiness, Success, and Spiritual Awakening in 7 Easy Steps. Now, the last step he discusses is what he calls the Law of Affirmation. And the Law of Affirmation is about doing with your life what makes you truly happy, and doing what you believe you have been put on this earth to do. And he asks you this question. I remember the first time I read it. It really affected me, you know? He asks,
how are you best suited to serve humanity?
I don't know if there's one thing I'm only suited for, but right now I'm in this pre-med program at school and I plan on specializing in pediatric oncology. But I am also really interested in sports medicine, particularly orthopedics. So definitely something in the medical profession.
I think I'm doing it right now. You know, cops are really underpaid psychiatrists when you get right down to it.
How am I best suited to serve humanity? Definitely not in fucking ShopRite, tell you that much.
How are you best suited to serve humanity.
And then you're supposed to answer that question and put it into practice.
Well, Kate, I wanted to talk with you because I have so enjoyed working here, and I really appreciate all the opportunities you've given me, but I've been thinking, and I wanted to let you know, I've decided that I really have to concentrate on finishing my novel because it's my first, and I just can't do that while I work full-time at an asphalt paving company. Not that there's anything wrong with paving asphalt. It's great.
Sun be any stronger in that room?
Isn't it great? It's like a built-in alarm clock.
Oh, I have three words for you. Black out curtains.
You ready for some coffee?
Are we going for a hike?
Well, first, I thought you could help me with a little project.
What project?
Well, it's just a little mailing. I thought it would be a good thing for me to submit one of my stories to some magazines.
You told me if I came up, we'd have fun.
This will be fun. I got us coffee. I bought us some donuts. We'll put on some Madonna. I already wrote half the cover letters.
Which story are you submitting?
Henry's knees.
Aww.
Yeah.
Field and Stream?
You never know.
Soldier of Fortune?
I know an assistant editor there. Ian, come on.
Is Teen Mademoiselle really the market you want?
I'm not really in a position to be picky, so.
Yeah, but what about professional standards? What about personal dignity? What is it? Oh, Chinana. Dear Miss Gowan, it has come to the attention of Volvo Finance Incorporated that you are over 60 days late in paying your state amount. Yeah? Perhaps this is an oversight on your part. Oh, if so, please remit payment right away. If your account is still outstanding by the above date, this matter will be turned over to a collection agency, yeah? Which may adversely affect your credit rating, yeah? And result in repossession of the automobile? Repo man. Are they at least gonna send over Amelia?
Maybe.
Jeez. Do not mess with Volvo. How much longer before it's paid off?
8 more months.
Do any of these magazines pay you money if you're published?
A lot. Teen Mademoiselle pays $2,000.
Really? All right. I will stuff, but you've got to do something for me.
Okay.
I want to see pages.
Pages. Ian, no, it is not finished. And it is very rough in some spots. No, it's not ready. It's not ready to be read. No. Well? Ian, come on, just tell me.
There is no doubt in my mind that you will have all the success you ever wanted, Watson. I mean it. The novel's great. It's truly fantastic.
You're shitting me.
No, I loved it. I more than loved. Oh my God, yo, you rock, girl. I volunteer my services as the official book touring companion. It is so good.
Oh God. Oh God, thank you.
No, thank you. I don't know what I would have said if it would have sucked.
So, Watson, how do you feel about side work?
Side work?
That's right. Side work.
I live for side work. Side work rocks my world. Also, did you notice I worked at Lutece, so I have some references.
Lutece.
So I got the job. Uniform. Black pants, button-down Oxford, black tie. I just found these at the Salvation Army. They're these really cool high-waisted stretch pants. They're kind of matador style. They're hot. He bought the Lutece bit.
Okay. Thanks. Have a good day.
It's golden delicious, actually. Yeah. Nice try, though.
Thanks. It's 478.
Always somebody else's car. Whenever it's a Dodge Aries, it's all my girlfriend, my brother-in-law. It's always somebody else that has a Dodge Aries. Nobody wants to admit.
Do you know what this form is all about?
Oh, that one. That's the liquor liability form. It means if someone, like, crashes their car after having dinner here, and is, like, paralyzed from the waist down, they can hold you personally responsible.
You mean if I sign this form, they can sue me instead of the restaurant?
Mm-hmm. But I wouldn't worry about it. You can just send the heavy drinkers to the bar. That way the bartender gets sued.
Watson, Mason, we just need to go over a couple of points that are part of the elect restaurant employee policy.
Why are you here?
I was a bad boy.
Mason sold 2 early bird specials 15 minutes after the early bird time limit had expired.
George and I don't spend enough quality time together.
Why don't we start on page 1 of the elect restaurant employee manual? That's the section on utensil deployment. We'll start with spoons and knives, okay? Okay. And lastly, if an elect employee is not able to comply with any or all of these rules, their position will immediately and irrevocably end in termination.
Termination?
That's the word they use.
Oh, that's nice.
So, Watson, you ready to trail for the evening?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Just remember, be courteous, of course, be attentive, and have fun. Remember, it's fun out there.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Can I just speak to you for 1 second?
Sure. Come
here. I just wanted to let you know that those pants aren't going to work.
You're kidding.
No.
What's wrong with them?
On page 18 of your manual, it specifically states there's supposed to be a crease down the front. Right there, it says that those pants have no crease. Just, you know. Pick up something else, okay?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, that's
okay. Well, maybe you should just go back to temping.
What about the Volvo?
Have you asked your mom to help you out again?
She said she didn't pay $80,000 for my college education to have me rely on her to support myself.
But you're a writer.
Aspiring writer.
It's her duty to support you.
I think she's still upset with me for being friends with you.
You know, you're the one who broke up with me.
Hank, you were obsessed with strippers.
Not obsessed. Intrigued. And don't change the subject.
Is there a subject here?
Yeah. How important is keeping the Volvo to you?
It's pretty important.
Hello. How are you tonight?
We're fine. We're just fine.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Would you like to hear our specials for the evening?
Well, first I think I'd like to start with something to drink.
Sure, of course. What can I get for you?
I don't know. I was thinking maybe something tropical. What's in your blue Hawaii?
Our blue Hawaii? Let me think. Rum. some food coloring. Jamaican spice. And, one of those little umbrella thingies. One blue Hawaii.
You said white bread. I put it on white bread. If you didn't want bread, tell me you don't want here for 10 minutes. Supposed to read your mind? Why is it so hot?
Excuse me, miss.
I've seen whiter tablecloths in prison.
Last time I ate here, I got food poisoning.
You work for me, and I'm only 15.
See? Her hair's brown. It must be hers. No potatoes, no tip.
Excuse me. Where's the manager?
Where's the manager?
Could I have some more parsley, please? Does the manager know you dress like that?
How is everything?
It's fine. It's very good.
Would you like another Blue Lagoon?
Blue Hawaii.
Once he told me the pants were out, I should have known. Those pants were the only thing with any style in the entire goddamn restaurant.
Can I help you, miss?
Valentino! It's me, Watson.
Watson?
Do you remember me?
Yes, of course I do. How are you? It's great to see you.
You too.
How's your beautiful mother?
She's good. She's good. Listen, I need to talk to you about something.
Sure, of course. Come on in.
Okay.
Watch the grapes.
Yes, thank you.
Your mother's still in Palm Beach?
Yeah. As far as I know, yeah.
Oh, good. It's a very nice place. Nice town, Palm Beach. That's very good for her.
Yeah, she likes it there a lot.
Okay, Watson. I want you to realize that if you sell through Volvo and exchange for another model, your dollar value is going to be very different. And to be perfectly honest with you, I don't think we can get you into anything we have on the lot.
Really, nothing?
And I mean, not even a 740.
Well, I mean, it doesn't have to be one of those select pre-owned jobs, you know. I mean, I'm not picky.
Yeah, well, we're just talking trade-in. We could buy your car from you outright.
What? How much could I get for it?
Well, it'd probably be a little lower than you're expecting. It's clearly not a fortune, but it's a fair price for a dealership.
Okay, you're kidding, right? I mean... Uh-uh. But, I mean, this is... I mean, do you know how much I've been paying Volvo just in interest alone? I mean, I deserve more just for the sheer pain I've been through. I
know, Watson. Believe me, I know. It's highway robbery.
Yeah, literally. Valentino, there must be a way I can make more money on it.
I think if you go through the classifieds, you'll do better if that's the route you're gonna go.
Classifieds. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Boggles the mind. Drive it off the lot and that's what you get, huh?
It drops.
Wanted. Very special owner for a 98 like new Volvo S70. Just over 30,000 miles. Same owner. Serious buyers respond only, please.
You have 16 new messages. First message, left today at 9:05 a.m.
Watson, I'm Dan Miller. I'm here to take a good look at your Volvo. You know your car?
Any accidents since then?
No.
Good.
Well, there was this little fender bender this past March, but we didn't even report it to the insurance company.
Oh, so you just sort of took matters into your own hands.
Well, I wouldn't necessarily call it that.
It's just so beautiful. I love its lines, you know? The way it curves at the front of the hood.
Yeah, I know. It's a real pretty car.
You know, Mom always told me the perfect girl for me to drive a Volvo.
Uh-huh.
Hey, there's a piece of mold missing here.
You told her your salary? Oh, please, tell me you're kidding me.
She seemed like a very sweet young lady. She doesn't work for the IRS.
Easy, easy there, Roberta.
It's just so shiny. You want to try it out? Sure. Can we take the top down? I think you better leave.
Well, I'm not leaving here until I see that goddamn Volvo.
So, Edna, what do you think?
You comfy?
F.
F minus. D plus is the best I have. D minus. Ugh.
See, I think you had it all wrong, you know?
In what way?
I think it shouldn't have been about how they all drove the car, but more about their personal sense of style in general.
I mean, it's not like this is Vermont.
Ian, I wasn't planning on dating them. I just wanted to make sure that they would have an implicit sense of how my car should be treated.
Oh, that's bullshit. Looks always count. I mean, look at this guy, for example. He is wearing jeans and black Reebok sneakers.
Ooh. Let me see.
Oh. Right away, you can tell he is not of your ilk.
Shit, he's looking at the car.
So?
So he probably has an appointment to see it. Quick, just hide, hide. He might see you. Just hide, Ian.
So what?
So he'll go away if he thinks no one is home.
Duh, your car is parked right outside.
Ian!
He knows you're home.
Hello? Down resident. Yep. Hold on a sec.
It's for you. It's a boy.
Where are you going?
I'm telling him the car's not for sale.
Hello.
Hi, I'm looking for Miss Watson Gowan.
This is Watson.
This is Fred Murray from Connecticut Telecom.
Okay, thanks. No thanks.
It is done.
How'd he take it?
He collapsed and cried hysterically.
Really? Hello.
Hello, my name is Kurt Jones. I received your name from a friend.
Why don't you just cut to the chase? Is this telemarketing?
No. It's nothing like that. I represent a company that helps women very much like yourself, work out of their home part-time.
Women very much like myself, huh?
Well, there's a greater demand for part-time work out of the home for women.
Well, what kind of work is it?
It would be customer service, a form of creative entertainment.
Uh-huh. And what would it involve?
It would involve taking phone calls from our customers and responding to their inquiries.
And what would the hours be?
You set the hours yourself.
How much does it pay?
For every call you take, we pay you $50.
Rock on!
Hello?
50, huh?
That's right.
Yeah, thanks. I think I'll pass.
Ew, that is so skeevy. How did he get my number?
You are such a prude.
Ian, not wanting to take a job as a phone sex operator does not make me a prude.
Beggars can't be choosers.
Are you referring to the money or the sex?
Both. That is good money.
Give me a break.
Not to burst your bubble or anything, but have you thought about what you're gonna do? Your car is in collection.
No, I haven't, and I am not going to for at least the next few days, if you don't mind. Ian, come on, you are supposed to be up here to cheer me up.
I am only trying to help, trying to open your eyes to the world of possibilities that exist beyond your conservative standard suburban life.
Oh, put a lid on it.
You know, I can go home anytime.
Watson, long time no speak. This is Captain Dirk Douglas calling. I know it's been a while, but I wanted to let you know I'm going to be flying a new route from Cleveland to Hartford starting tomorrow, and I thought we could get together.
Me.
I met Watson on a flight from over here to Hartford. Wasn't your typical pickup, because she came into the cockpit, introduced herself to us, and said that she was afraid to fly, and that this would be her first flight without drugs. She wanted to make sure that we knew what we were doing. So I told her it was our first flight without taking drugs, too.
I just thought he was very handsome. And I don't know, I guess I was having this vicarious thrill being in the cockpit for so long, talking to this pilot.
She was real cute. We talked for quite a while. She flirted outrageously with me until we had to get back to the pre-flight track.
And then ironically, what ended up happening was the flight was delayed because they couldn't fix the calibrator.
So obviously, standard procedure. Although I think we would have been just fine without it. We returned to the gate so that the mechanic could get a better look at it.
God, we probably talked for over an hour by the time they fixed the thingamajig. And by then, we had plans for dinner.
Come on, Hank, that is such a double standard.
What is that supposed to mean?
What's wrong with giving Dirk a second chance? I'm trying to chase a piece of the action, and you're getting all upset.
Hey, Watson. Believe me, I want you to get laid. You need to get laid. I just think that this flyboy guy sounded like a prick, that's all.
Well, I don't agree.
Oh, well, isn't he the one that, you know, fell asleep?
I did not fall asleep. Well, I mean, I did, but not right away. You see, at first, Watson sort of took the bull in her hands, literally. And, right. Well, the thing was, once I let loose, I mean, I had been up at 4 a.m. that morning,
with a pre-flight check by 7. The flight I met Watson on was my second that day. You know how it is. You don't know how exhausted you are until you reach a state of total relaxation. And then, sometimes you just can't help yourself. I shut my eyes for a few seconds. Up until that point, I had every intention of reciprocating. So I said to him, I said, look, you can write me a ticket, but both you and I know that you're not writing me a ticket because I'm parked in a no standing zone. You're either writing me a ticket because you've been told to fulfill some quota for parking violations in a given day, or you're under pressure to raise revenue for the governor's limo budget. But please don't insult either one of our intelligences by pretending that you're giving me a ticket because I'm parked in a no standing zone.
Skip dinner entirely tonight.
I like the sounds of that.
Just want you to know that I don't always fall asleep. Lean back.
Thank you. Lean back.
Lean back and tell me if you want or need anything different whatsoever. I am living and breathing only to please you. Anything you want.
So, Dirk, I was wondering, how have you envisioned the evening?
Envision the evening? Gee, ooh. You know, except for getting a bite to eat or something, I don't know. I didn't envision any one thing for the evening.
Oh.
In my best estimation, I'd have to say he's lying.
Oh, yeah. He's lying.
I don't know. Maybe he didn't really expect anything from her. Maybe he just wanted to visit with her.
French kiss me?
All I wanted was to get laid. I mean, that's it. That's all.
I just don't feel comfortable French kissing someone I don't know that well. That's all.
The fact that he kept saying French kissing, I mean, I felt like I was in some kind of Judy Blume novel.
Look, it's nothing personal. I mean, I'm that way with everyone. I just can't French kiss someone I don't know.
It's all right, Dirk, really. I understand.
Well, what are you doing that for? We were doing fine.
Dirk, the next time you're flying from Cleveland to Hartford and you think about calling me, don't.
You don't have to leave.
Watson, wait.
Yes?
I just wanted to say that, I just wanted to tell you that,
Yes?
If you plan on writing a story about this or something, could you just make sure to change my name?
I don't know. Maybe I'm crazy, but I think it takes a very special kind of person, a very special kind of woman, to not get laid. Really. Think about that. You have a life.
You have a life!
Hank, I live in New Haven, Connecticut, okay? Largest importer of heroin in the United States and home of the brick oven pizza.
Clam pizza.
What?
Isn't it home of the white clam pizza?
Oh, God, I don't know. It probably is. See, if I had a life there, I would know that. I don't know. I mean, when I lived here, I had a job that paid well. I went out a lot. I threw parties, you know? I mean, maybe good work is only inspired by good living.
Oh, please, please, don't even go down that road. Because that is just a big New York lie. The fact of the matter is that right now that you're in a slump because you got terminated. That's all. That's what this is about. That and you're jonesing because you're coming to the end of your first draft. That's it.
And I've been rejected from 15 magazines.
And your interaction with the opposite sex is kind of at an all-time low right now.
Okay, it's non-existent.
Okay, so my point is that crisis is a bad time to judge your choices.
And crisis helps you make choices.
You know, Truman Capote was rejected by the New Yorker for years, and he was working there.
Truman Capote published his first novel when he was 23. Mm-hmm.
Well, now that would look nice in your backyard.
Way too big.
The little guy.
Mm-mm.
It would make a statement.
That it would.
Okay. So you're running a little bit behind schedule. Fine. My point is, okay, doubt everything else. But don't doubt your work, because that's supposed to be your life right now. And that's what makes you different from the rest of us.
Thanks, Hank.
It was okay?
That was good.
One to Jimmy Stewart?
It was a little Jimmy Stewart, but I like Jimmy Stewart. I like him a lot.
Promise me again.
Watson, I can't believe you don't touch me.
Do it.
I swear on the Volvo steel god himself, I will not say anything embarrassing when we go through Jack's cash register.
Okay, good.
But you have to promise me that you're gonna
ask your help. He and I am in no way near being ready to ask him.
And he's going to be ready to ask him out.
Come on, just bite the bullet and do it.
It is way too crowded in here, and I am not in the mood.
Oh, that is total bullpup.
It is not. I am still recovering from all those car interviews. Besides, the backer girl is here.
Hi.
Hi. Crowded here for the weekend, huh?
Yeah, I know. I don't know what it is. You think there's gonna be a blizzard or something?
I know, my God. Maybe they know something we don't.
Maybe.
There's a hurricane warning.
Excuse me?
They're saying Hurricane Jane might hit us tonight.
Oh, yes, thunderstorm.
Yeah, but it's not even raining.
I'm just telling you what they're saying.
Ray.
That comes to 3468.
Great.
Out of 40. $5.32 is your change.
Wow, thanks.
All right, have a good day.
You too. I hope your shift ends soon.
Hopefully before last call.
Yeah, right. I know what you mean. Well, be well.
Bye.
Bye. Thanks. Bye.
Bye.
I am not your friend anymore.
Ian, come on. At least I made conversation. Actually, I think that went really well. I mean, that is the most conversational we have ever been together. That was a big step. I feel really good about that. I didn't actually ask him out, but it wouldn't have been the right time to do it then. Besides, I am sure a good opportunity to talk more will present itself in the near future, and when it does, I'll be ready. In the meantime, I'll just keep coming in to pick up groceries. Hey, now there's an idea. Oh, my God. Oh, my God, I am going to kill him. I'm going to kill you. Ian, what did you do?
Nothing. I just invited him to the party, that's all.
What party?
The party you're throwing tonight at your house.
Ian, but I am not throwing a party tonight.
You are?
No. Ian, I can't. I mean, even if I wanted to, I couldn't because there would be nobody there.
I'll help with that.
Help how? By handing out flyers at Home Depot?
That's an idea.
I was really surprised when her friend came over and told me to come. I mean, I just figured she thought I was a cashier just like all the rest of the customers do. I mean, she does come in a lot, though. I mean, even if it is to just buy a cucumber or something. And she always uses my register, but I just figured she didn't know we had an express lane.
Just guys.
Actually, a little bit more.
So you never want to use a metal spoon. Because actually, if you use a metal spoon, it adds this kind of like a metallic flavor.
Isn't that clever? Isn't Yo, clever? What's up? How you doing?
Hi, I'm Winona.
Oh, hi. Hi, Harry Watson.
I love your place. Mm-hmm. Hank told me all about it. It's totally different than I imagined.
Mm-hmm. Thanks. So where do you live? In the city? Downtown?
No, actually Upper East Side.
Oh, really? Where about?
73rd and 5th?
You live on 5th Avenue?
In a penthouse, no less.
Actually, I bought it for the views, although I paid about $200 too much for it.
Shit. Maybe I should start stripping.
That's what I've
only
been trying to
get. Well, actually, it's a very lucrative.
He's here! If you want.
Oh,
he's here!
Oh, my God, Sheila!
Calm down. No, my
stomach really hurts.
I know. Just breathe.
Just breathe. I think I'm starting to sweat.
No, you're not sweating. Maybe a little bit.
Hey, do you know where I could get the keg is? Because these ladies gave me my drink.
Right in the kitchen.
Thanks, man.
Sure. Watson!
Hank! Do, get out of here.
He went to get beer.
Well, I am sure he will find me when he comes back.
Okay, well.
Do you see him?
I think I'll just leave you alone right
now. Is he coming?
Maybe not right now. That boy can cut a rug.
Yeah, with the wrong people.
I'm sure he'll get to you eventually. I mean, he seems to be making the rounds.
When the sun comes up? I mean, what the hell is wrong with him? This is my goddamn party, and I look hot as shit. He should be falling over himself to get to me.
You know what I think you should do? I think you should go on out there, and you should just start dancing, you know? You just go on up to him and be like, hey, what's up? You know what I'm saying? Come on. What do you got to lose? Start moving. Do what I'm doing.
I mean, first you, and then Ian.
Shh. Dance. Okay. Dance, that's it. Oh. Ooh, get on.
Take a stand, because you're the man. And do what you want to do, you know you got the plan. And all the people all around, they stop and stare at what you found. You found the only living reason to believe. You want, and you feel it all around you, and you get it,
Come on in.
Hi.
Hi. Sit down.
Oh, thanks.
You can sit closer than that.
Oh.
So.
So.
So. How was the rest of your shift?
Uneventful. I got yelled at for not, selling somebody Wonder Bread.
Really?
Yeah. I don't even know how people eat that shit. It's so completely unnatural, you know?
I never eat Wonder Bread.
That's good.
Only whole wheat. I was raised on it.
Oh, that's very good.
Come here. Come on. Come lie next to me. It's really comfy. Jack?
Mm-hmm.
I just wanted you to know I'm really glad you came by tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God, I'm sorry. Are you okay?
I think so. It's not bleeding, is it?
No. I just remembered I have to feed my cat.
Your cat?
Yeah. I'm not usually out this late. He's probably freaking out.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Jack!
Yeah?
I just thought maybe you'd like to kiss me goodnight.
Oh. Maybe you should kiss me.
Okay.
Thanks for having me.
Sure.
All right, I'll see you. Do you want this door open or shut?
Shut.
Bye.
Is the whole cat thing. I mean, I thought most cats preferred to be by themselves.
So what was this guy's name?
Kurt Jones.
I thought he sounded pretty affable.
So when did the words phone sex come up?
They didn't. He called it creative entertainment.
Yeah, he said it was $50 a phone call.
So are you gonna do it?
Hank, of course not. I'd rather work at ShopRite before I do that.
Even now?
I am just never gonna be with another man again, am I?
Hey, speaking of, some guy left a message while you were in the shower. It's on the machine.
Was it for the Volvo?
I don't know. Yo, Mrs. Butterworth's gonna be spreading herself all over my sala.
Let me in. Move over. Ooh. Watch, flip. Watch.
I see a half flip.
She had an ad in the Daily Register to sell her Volvo.
You can tell a lot about someone from an ad like that. I mean, for instance, how do they describe their automobile? Do they have a sense of pride in their vehicle? Do they care what kind of person responds to their ad? That looks great. I love photographs. There are certain very distinct female traits in any copy. Her ad said, very special owner wanted. So I called her machine. I got a hard on the first time I heard her voice.
Hey.
Nice, huh?
Hello.
Hi, is this Watson?
Speaking.
Hi, Watson. This is Kurt Jones. We spoke a while ago about the customer service position.
Uh-huh.
I thought maybe you had some time to think about it.
No, not really.
Well?
I thought maybe I could give you a little more information about it if you'd like.
Hello?
So it really pays 50 a phone call?
Right. If you keep the caller on longer than 15 minutes.
Uh-huh.
Which isn't hard. I mean, you've got a really great voice, and you're intelligent and obviously imaginative. I give you about a week before you start making really good money.
Uh-huh. How did you get my number again? Listen, I gotta go.
Well, Watson, I'd really like you to consider it. Would you at least do that?
It's Kurt, right?
That's right.
Yeah. I'm sorry, Kurt, but I'm really not interested.
Just think about it.
Does anyone call up and talk about politics or the news or art?
Well, the calls really vary from person to person. You'd be surprised.
When you're trying to get past the 15-minute mark, are they, like, getting to know you, or are they, like, getting to know you?
Okay, look, here's how the calls break down. Basically, you have your outright sex calls. For those, the guys are going to want you to masturbate for them. The other calls are going to ask you to caress yourself, but you don't have to come. If you touch yourself in any way, they're going to tip you $50. And that's on top of the $50 you're already getting for keeping them on past the first 15.
Jesus, lay it on the line.
You asked.
Hey, Kurt, how'd you shoot?
44 on the back, 43 in the front. 87.
How'd you shoot?
I played golf today. I knew I had her after the second phone call. If you can keep them on the line past the first 10 seconds, you got them hooked. Thanks, Jackie. Yeah. I used to touch myself when I talked to her.
So are you gonna do it?
Are you kidding? No way. I would never. No.
It's basically prostitution.
Well, that's bullshit. We all prostitute ourselves in one way or another.
It's all about selling a product. It doesn't matter whether you're selling coffee or whether you're selling sex.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Die.
Still, the thing is, if I took two calls a day, 5 days a week, I could pay off the car in 4 months.
If something sounds too good to be true, Watson, it usually is.
Well, Watson, it sounds to me like the Volvo is becoming a little more trouble than it's worth, and I've given something a lot of thought, and I want you to hear me out. Will you do that for Mumsy, sweetie cakes?
Okay.
I've searched my soul on this. I really have. I've been thinking about it for days. And I mean, you're not going back and forth to New York as much as we thought you would, and I... Mom!
Just spit it out.
I think you should consider selling it.
Hi, it's Kurt.
All right, I'm in. Set one up for tomorrow. Hello?
Yeah, is this Watson?
Yes.
This is Sam.
Hi, Sam. How are you?
Oh, darling, I'm great. I've been looking forward to talking to you all week.
Have you now?
You sound incredible, darling.
Thank you.
Why don't you tell me about yourself?
What would you like to know?
Well, you could start by telling me what you're wearing.
This is great. Actually, I have on a floor-length negligee. It's really lovely. It's sort of an iridescent periwinkle, and it's got this great little scallop top and a matching robe that goes with it. And I have on the cutest marabou slippers. I mean, they've got these little fluffy white tops. I mean,
where are you?
I have been lying in bed all day just touching myself, waiting to talk to you.
Oh, God, your voice. Just listening to you makes me want to come.
Thank you. So, tell me about you. What do you do for a living, Sam?
I'm a tax accountant.
Really? How interesting. You must be busy this time of year. Shouldn't you be at the office right now?
I'm on my lunch hour.
Good, good, I'm glad. Where are you, at home?
I'm in bed. I only have my boxers on. My snake is standing up and rattling for you, darling. It's waiting to fuck you so hard.
So then what happened?
Well, then he started saying shit like, imagine me taking you from behind. Imagine me slamming you so hard, the only noise you'd hear would be the sound of my balls slapping against your ass and the sound of you begging me for more.
No,
I did too, I swear.
So then what happened?
Can you hear that?
Uh-huh.
Did you like it?
Oh, yeah, baby.
That's the sound of my cock dripping and wet for you.
And so then, of course, it dawns on me that this guy doesn't have any fucking clue what I'm doing. I mean, he doesn't know if I'm, like, licking my breasts or picking my ass. Plus, I was starting to get so nauseated, I just decided I had to get him to come and get the whole thing over with.
These calls.
Hello.
Hi, it's me. How'd it go with Sam? He wants to talk to you again tomorrow.
No way, no how, uh-uh.
Why? Well, Watson, what happened?
I did not enjoy that experience at all, Kurt.
Well, Sam seemed to.
Yeah, well, I think Sam would have gotten off to a dial tone.
Oh, well, I've got someone else who wants to talk to you.
No, no more calls until I get paid.
Payroll is until the end of the week.
Fine, then I'll wait until then. Hello?
Watson. Let's do a call.
Excuse me?
Let's do a call right now.
I'm sorry, you want me to take a call from a client right now?
I want you to do a call with me.
Oh. You know, I have to go out. Bye.
Couldn't you have gotten a job at a strip club or something?
And maybe next time.
Okay, so what are the three steps that you're gonna do if this sicko calls you again?
I'm going to tell him I am not interested in taking any more calls.
Right, no explanations. And if he calls again?
I'm gonna tell him to stop calling or the police will trace his phone calls.
Which we never actually do, but he doesn't need to know that. And if he keeps on calling?
I'll let you know.
Exactly. Look, here's my number at the station.
I'm usually at my desk in the morning, so if you need to reach me, that's where I'll be.
Believe it or not, I am college educated. It's...
What's the first thing they teach you in kindergarten, Watson? What's the very first thing?
Don't throw sand?
Don't talk to strangers.
I know. It's sad. I've just been going through a transitional phase. Thank you for coming by, officer. I really appreciate it.
Well, it's my pleasure. Give me a call if you have any more trouble, okay?
I will.
You set up the house nice.
Oh, great. Thanks. Have a good day.
I had a hard time walking away from that one. But hey, at least I tried.
You know, I never did get a check for that one call. What can you do? I tried. Jack, I haven't seen him here in a while.
He moved to Alaska.
Alaska? Wow, that's far.
He was always going off about working for Greenpeace.
Yeah, I could see that. Alaska's probably a good place for him.
You could see that?
Well,
he told me you guys never went out. He told me that nothing ever happened between you two.
It didn't. I mean, it didn't.
Oh, save it. I could tell that you wanted him from that time he rang you through that day you bought three heads of Boston.
It was Greenleaf.
It was Boston.
Look, I mean, maybe I did want him, but that doesn't mean that he wanted me back.
I've got it, all right?
Listen, if I had known the two of you were, I mean, I wasn't trying to steal him or do anything that would damage your relationship. I didn't even know you two had a relationship.
What did you want us to do, hump each other over the scanner?
I don't know, that might appeal to some people.
You know, it goes to show that you give and you get burned, and that's just how it is. And he's not coming back from Alaska anytime soon, so you can stop casing the joint.
Right. Look, I'm sorry I upset you, okay? Really, I'm sorry. Thanks for the groceries and thanks for the baggies.
You didn't upset me, all right? To be totally honest with you, he wasn't even officially my boyfriend.
Well, good. You know, I'm glad. He's kind of weird, you know?
I know. He was totally obsessed with his cat. But that's what I liked about him.
You know, it's not true what you said. You don't get burned every time you give.
Do you really think so?
Well, I don't know. Maybe it's been a bad year all over. But, you know, I really appreciate your coming over. That was cool. Okay. It was nice talking to you. I'll see you next time, okay?
Dear Ms. Gowan, Teen Mademoiselle is proud to announce we have selected your story for first prize. We have enclosed your award money for a total of... Oh, my God! Oh, my God! $2,000! Henry's knees! Oh, my God! Oh, my God! I won! $2,000! I won!
You work in restaurant before?
Yeah.
How about diner? You work in diner before?
No, I haven't.
Same thing. A little faster, maybe, that's all.
That's okay, I'm good at fast.
So, when do you want to start?
How about tomorrow?
How about the day after tomorrow? You come. My daughter Debbie show you around. You get familiar with everything. You feel comfortable, we'll give you a few tables. Oh, if you can't stay, you start the next day, maybe.
That's terrific. Great. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you. What about the uniform?
We'll give you a t-shirt. Otherwise, a black skirt, black pants, sneakers.
Right, sneakers. Are these pants okay?
Yeah, sure. Fine.
Okay, great. Thank you so much. And I will see you the day after tomorrow, 3:00.
Okay.
3:00.
That when you combine it with glucosamine, which we've heard about some ladies, as well as men's
daily.
License and registration, ma'am, please. Hey, it's you, Watson, right? How you doing?
Oh, my God, I don't believe this.
Damn, you're driving like a maniac, Watson. You went through that stop sign. You're not drunk, are you?
No. I just was leaning over to get a tape, which fell under the seat, and every time I leaned over, I couldn't reach it, and I was going like this with the steering wheel each time. It really doesn't matter. God, I can't believe it's you.
you have any more trouble with that guy, that phone sex guy?
No more trouble.
Good. I was wondering about that. I mean, I figured everything was okay because you never gave me a call.
I was gonna call you to tell you it worked out, but I don't know, I never did.
Well, life goes on. You find another job yet?
Yeah, I waitress.
Oh, excellent.
At a diner, not a strip club.
Oh, good. Good to hear it. What are you, coming home from work right now?
Oh, no, I was just driving around now, really. Just killing some time. How about you?
Yeah, me too.
I'm covering for a friend. This isn't usually my shift.
So you're gonna test me for drunk driving? God, what a record I have with you. Drunk driving and phone sex.
No. I can tell you haven't been drinking.
Oh, yeah? How?
Well, you know, been doing it for a while. You can just tell.
How?
Actually, it's in the eyes. You can tell a lot from looking in someone's eyes.
Oh.
Well, I gotta get the car back to the station. Pretty much done for the day.
Thank you for not giving me a ticket.
Oh, no problem. I was heading over to the, after my shift, I was gonna go get an ice cream cone. I was wondering if you'd like to come along. I'm sorry, that's probably, that's
I'd
inappropriate.
Love to.
Really? I mean, yeah. You know, just because I am in uniform doesn't mean that you're required by law to go.
Well, yes, I figured that, Mr. Rusatelli, Officer Rusatelli.
Hey, all right, you know my name.
As well, it's on your shirt. And also, you gave me a card, you know, when you,
Right, I did, didn't I, Austin? So it's not that impressive.
So, Wentworth's, is that okay for you?
Yeah, it's, isn't it just right up the road here?
Yeah. About a mile up. 20 minutes? Is that too long to make you wait?
No, it's not.
I'll see you there.
Turn me out for tricks.